Assalamu alaikum, dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah in this pandemic situation. Dear students, our today's topic is active to passive of interrogative sentence. In our last class, we learned about active to passive of affirmative sentence, and now we will be learning about active to passive of interrogative sentence. So, in this segment, we will have actually four rules in total. And the first rule will be about interrogative without WH question. So actually interrogative can be of two types, that is with WH question and without WH question. And our first rule is about interrogative without WH question. So let me tell you something, that actually there is no exact rule of interrogative sentence of active to passive. So what we can do actually, we can turn it into passive following few steps, and those steps will be like this. Suppose you have an interrogative sentence like "Are you playing football?" is the interrogative sentence. So what we have to do first, we have to turn this interrogative sentence into affirmative sentence. So the affirmative form of this sentence will be "You are playing football." And now we have to put a full stop here. Okay. So this is an affirmative sentence, and you can make it passive according to the rules of affirmative sentence what we learned in our previous class. So now we will make it passive. That is, first we have to make that interrogative sentence into affirmative, and then we have to make it passive sentence. Right here, the passive form of this sentence will be "Football. I'm taking the object as the subject." Then to be verb, that is, and we'll have a be here, and we have to add ing with that be verb. Football is being. Then verb 3, that is first participle form of the verb, play. Then a by will come here. Then objective form of the subject, a full stop. Here we have 5 points. Actually what we follow it in our affirmative rules also. Like this is point number 1, this is to be verb point number 2, this is point number 3, point number 4, and 5. So now active to passive is done, but actually we were asked to turn an active to passive of interrogative sentence. But what we have done here, we have made active to passive of affirmative sentence. So finally, actually what we have to do, we have to turn this one into interrogative sentence again, like interrogative sentence. Okay, so to turn it interrogative, what we have to do, we have to bring that auxiliary verb at the beginning of the sentence, and we also have to put an interrogative mark at the end, like "Is football being played by you?" Okay, so this is the final answer of this question, and these are the rough portion what we have to follow. Actually there are a few steps as I told you earlier. So following these steps, you can make any interrogative sentence active to passive, but you have to remember that should be without WH question. Okay, so now we will know interrogative sentence with WH question. So here actually we will have three rules. The first one will be about who So in this rule, we have to follow also some stage. That is, suppose you have an interrogative sentence starting with who WH question, like who is teaching you English. So what to do actually here, we have to turn it directly passive. We have to turn it directly into passive. We don't need to make it assertive. Okay, so if the sentence is being started with WH question who, then we will make it passive directly like this. Passive. The passive form will be here. Actually, we have two objects. That's why we will bring the first one as the subject of our passive sentence, like you. Then we have our own auxiliary verb, but we have to take R here according to the subject. A B will come here, and we have to add ing with that very B. And you are being, that is point number one, point number two. Then past participle form of the verb. Taught. You are being taught. This is point number three. Now the second object must come here, English. Then by an objective form of the subject who, that is whom. So if you see carefully, you will find that this sentence has been made into an affirmative sentence. Now we can't call it an interrogative sentence. That's why we can't put any interrogative mark here. Rather, we have to put full stop here. Okay. But we were asked to turn an interrogative sentence into passive. But the passive has become itself an assertive sentence. So now we will make it interrogative first. That means after making passive, we have to make it interrogative. Interrogative. So for making it interrogative, we have to bring the auxiliary verb at the beginning, like are you being taught English, then by whom. So now we can put an interrogative sign here. So we can say that we are done with this point, but there is an issue also here, that is this very WH question, this very WH question, whom. Actually, you should know that in interrogative sentence, we can't put any WH question at the middle or at the end of the sentence. Rather, we must put it at the very beginning of the sentence. So what we have to do here, we have to bring that by whom at the very beginning of the sentence to make it a correct interrogative sentence. Okay? By whom will come at the very beginning. So the final answer will be like this. By whom are you being taught English? So this is our, so students, this is rule number three for you, and it's about WH question whom, which is the objective form of WH question who. So if you have any interrogative sentence to turn it into passive, which is being started with a WH question whom, then you should follow this rule. And the rule will be like this. Suppose you have an interrogative sentence starting with whom, like whom are you teaching English? So this is an example of interrogative sentence starting with whom. And if you are asked to make it passive, then first you have to bring this whom after the verb. Because if you see, you will find that this whom is actually in its objective form. But it is in the place of a subject in a sentence. So what you have to do first, you have to put it in its objective place or in the place of object in the sentence, that is after the verb. So you can write it like this. Whom as object. So whom as object, like, are you teaching whom then English? The sentence is still in interrogative form. So now we have to turn it into assertive form by bringing the auxiliary after the subject, that is, you are teaching whom English. Now we have to put a full stop here because the sentence is now in assertive form. So students, now you can make it passive form. So to make it passive, you should bring the object of the active sentence as the subject of the passive sentence. But you can see that there are actually two objects here. First one is whom and the second one is English. And we know that if we have two objects in your active sentence, then we should bring the first one as the subject of the passive sentence. So now we will make it passive like this. Whom will come here as the subject and it will be who. Actually, who is the subjective form of whom? Then the work of to be verb, that is, then we should take a be verb here and add ing with the be. Then past participle form of the verb. Now the second object must be put here after the verb. So English, and then you can put your by and you. So this is actually point number one, point number two, point number three, and point number four, point number five. This is actually the second object. So we are done with our passive. So now we have to see if the sentence is in interrogative form or not. So if you see the structure of this sentence, you'll find that it's in interrogative form. So that's why you don't need to make it interrogative again. Rather, itself it being interrogative here, so we can put an interrogative sign here, and that is the final answer of the question starting with. So this is actually the final rule or rule number four, and it's about WH question except who or whom. That is the all other WH questions except who or whom, you should follow this rule. And that is, suppose you have an interrogative sentence here, like, what are you doing tonight? So then what you have to do, you have to remove that WH question first. You should keep it aside from the sentence. That means, after cutting this part, you will have, are you doing tonight? And this is an interrogative one. So then, you have to make it assertive first. Because we know that without turning an interrogative into assertive, we can't make it passive. So that's why we should turn it assertive. That is, you are doing tonight, and we are putting a full stop here. Then we have to make it passive. But if you see, you will find that there is no object here. That's why we can't bring anything as the subject of the passive sentence. And for this reason, we are keeping it empty here. Then we are following point number two, that is we are using to be verb here. Then we are putting a participle form of the verb, which is point number three. Then we are putting by here, which is point number four. And finally, we are putting subject as the object here, which is point number five. And tonight, as an adverb, is being put in its own place. So, as our passive is done, what we have to do, we have to put our WH question in its own place finally. What we are doing here, from passive, we should put WH question. That means we are putting this WH question. This WH question, which we kept aside at the very beginning of starting our rule, we are now putting this part or this WH question at the beginning of our passive sentence. And the whole answer will be like this: what's being done by you tonight? So dear students, this actually some steps actually you have to follow in this point. And if you follow all these steps which I have already shown you, you can turn any interrogative sentence into passive. And that's all about interrogative sentence from active to passive. And we have four rules in total, which I have already shown you in this video. Hopefully you all have understood all the things in the class, and you are already given a worksheet in your school website. Please download it and solve yourself. If you face any problem, you can knock me at Viber. And thank you very much for joining the class.